Hello there, this is Isaac Tanui, and my presentation today is titled Economic Impact of GOP or Trump's Tax Reform. I'll begin with giving the reasons behind the tax reform as given to us by the GOP. And one of the reasons is surrounding jobs. And according to the GOP, or rather Trump, Donald Trump, the president, he's saying that few Americans are working. And of course, according to the statistics that I was given by the Bureau of Labor Statistics, Eurostat, August 2017, the employment rate is at 4.4. And when you compare this to the United Kingdom, we could be a little bit better off than them because we are at 4.4 and they are at around 4.8. So we are a bit better off than them. Another reason given by the GOP for this tax reform is that there are too many jobs shipped abroad. Another reason given to us is that too many middle class families cannot make ends meet. Those are some. So now this is the blueprint for tax reform by the GOP, and this is as given to us as reported by the CNN September 7th, 2017. And one of the strategies is to lower the business rates, and we're beginning with corporates, which they will reduce from 35% to 20%. And then for small businesses, they will reduce the taxes from 39.6 to 25%. The individual income tax, they're going to shrink according to the projection, the tax brackets from 7 to 3. And these are in three categories. The three categories, I will begin with the lowest rate, lowest at 12%, and then our middle will be at 25%, and the top rate is at 35%. However, there are chances that they're going to add another bracket, which may be around 40, or speculation that there will be an additional fourth bracket for that. But this is basically the simplification of the tax bracket on individual taxes. Something else that they will do on this tax reform is they're going to double the standard deductions. And this is for a standard deduction, according to IRS, is an amount that is subject to tax and reduces taxpayers' bills. So this would be something good. Additionally, they are going to repeal alternative minimum tax, and this would be an incentive that affects earners between 200,000 to 1 million earners. They are also going to eliminate the estate tax, and this is for actually earners between $5.5 million. And then also finally they are going to increase a child tax credit, and also I believe according to the projection they are going to increase the bracket, the earnings bracket for those who qualify for this tax credit, child tax credit. When we focus on economics, as far as this earnings is concerned, the consumption choices in relation to projected income, it has to do with the budget line, all right? So the budget line relevant for consumption choices over time depends on the current and future income. So if we have a budget line going down like that, and we have product one and product two. We assume that this is our budget line, and we assume that, let's say, this is 2017, and we are on our this year's tax rate, and we presume that the amount that we go home with, or rather the income, is lower this year because of the current tax brackets or tax marginal tax. But with the presumption that we're going to earn more next year, a change in any of these variables, let's say the income, of course, will alter the budget line and affect the market basket. So if this was my earnings this year, let's say it's X, this is my this would be my market basket that I would choose. There could be other people who would be choosing around here. There could be another person choosing, let's say this is A and this is B. So if my salary increases, my income goes up next year, my budget line will, of course, and we presume here that the prices of goods A and B will remain fixed. So what happens with my budget line is that it actually goes up like that, and I'll have a new budget line over here, and this would be my market, my market basket that I'll choose for this next year, assuming that the GOB tax reform, of course, will give us more earnings. So, income consumption curve. Now, when we look at this, this is my income consumption curve. All right. Those are the curves. This is for somebody else and for somebody else. Another consumer. This is my income. Consumption curve. So what happens here is that increase in real income with prices of goods fixed, of course, will mean that my choice of market basket will change. So this is assuming that it's this year where the market basket is, of course, it's limited to my income. But if I get an increase in my income, this would be my new market basket. And of course, I'll have an increase in what I can purchase now because of my income. All right. So according to the current tax plan, I'm going to show in the next slide, that the current is that we have 7 tax brackets, and I'm going to show the percentages. For the first bracket, it's 10%, and then the next bracket is 15%, the other bracket is 25%, and then 28%, the other bracket is 33%, and then 35%, and then 39.6%. Now, this is the current. This is the current tax law, or the marginal tax rate on ordinary income. This is for individual taxes. And of course, we divide here into 3 categories: head of household, and then the next one would be singles, and then the other one would be married and joint. So these are the 7 tax brackets that the GOP is trying hard to change. So we're going to look at a simple calculation of income taxes using the 7 tax brackets according to the current tax rate. So let's make an assumption that my taxable income is $120,000. So that would give me, and I'm filing married joint. So if we go by the tax bracket, the first tax bracket would give me 10% times 18, 550, and then plus the next. So we have an overflow. The difference between 120,000 and 1855, and the highest bracket that we can have over there. So, which is 75. 300 times the next bracket would be 15%, and then plus removing, we still have some overflow, and that would be that would give us the remaining would be 26,450, so it would be plus 26,450 times 25%. So that would give us 1,855 plus 11,295 plus 6,612.5, which of course our taxable, our taxes is 19,762.5. If we actually used the proposed tax plan, we'll only have three tax brackets, and they will be 12%, 25%, and 3%. So if I took the same salary that I would be earning, which is 120,000, assuming that that is my this is my taxable income. So the first bracket, let's say as a married and filing married and joint, would be 0 to 75,000. So the first 75,000, so the first 75,000 are multiplied by 12%, and then plus what is remaining after the difference between 120 and 75,000 would give us 45,000. So the 45,000 times 25%. Now that is the oversimplification of the taxes. Individual tax, where you only have the first tax bracket, the second, and the third. And most probably they will introduce the fourth one, which I don't know what it will be. And so when you add these two, our tax will be 20,000. 250, which if you look at it, we assume that there's some other deductions. There could be some changes, there could be more, we could be having more taxes to pay, or we may have more. But remember, this is a projection. Just a reminder, remember, as far as business tax is concerned, and going by the reform plan, we'll have no they're going to lower the maximum corporate tax from 35% to 20%. They lower the maximum rate, tax rate for small businesses to 25%, and then a 25% rate for pass-through business instead of being taxed for individual rates, and then personal income will not be taxed at this rate. And there's also a one-time repatriation tax for all overseas assets of US owned. But just remember this, that when it comes to tax reform, the devil is in the details. And that is according to the CNN 2017. Remember the GOP, the plan, that is the GOP plan. First of all, they're going to eliminate the itemized taxes. But, except we'll only have an exemption of mortgage interest. We also have charitable giving, and then we have retirement and higher education. On personal tax changes, bottom individual tax rate of 12%, middle 25%, and top, which is 35%, with the possibility of fourth or higher bracket. There's also largest standard deduction. So the standard deduction would be increased to 12,000 for individuals, up to 6,350, and 24,000 for married couples, up from 12,700. So slight changes. Also, they're going to eliminate most itemized deductions, as I earlier said, except for charitable gifts and home mortgage, interest, property taxes, and retirement savings. There'll also be repeals alternative minimum tax, and then there'll be increased size of child tax credit. And also, they're going to make the first 1,000 of child tax credit refundable. They'll make this refundable, and then an increased income level at which the credit will be phased out. Great. So if we look at this from an economic point of view, when you apply this to the model of supply and demand, model of supply and demand, remember we have the market equilibrium, and remember over here, so the price adjusts until it is supplied equals to quantity demand. Therefore, this point where these two curves is actually the market equilibrium. But then let's think about it this way. What happens if we have a change in income going by the proposed tax reforms? We all need to know that any rise in income causes the demand to increase. That is the law of supply and demand. So you have your supply and you have your demand, assuming that this is our equilibrium. That's our equilibrium. This is a quantity, this is a price, and this is 60, and this is 21. So this is, and then so rising income, it means we can buy more, so that means we're demanding more quantity. So that increases. At any price, the consumer now wants more quantity, therefore shifting the demand curve to the right. So you want more, so you can buy more, so the demand curve will go down there. Right, and this is demand, and then demand two. And we assume that this is as a result of the tax reform. Okay, so this would be, and it doesn't really, as far as the price is concerned, we can purchase more, and it doesn't really matter the price because we have more to actually spend, more money. And so that's how it is. So therefore the demand curve shifts to the right, and you have quantity two and the price down there. That's my presentation for today. Thank you.